Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll see how to use the unfold, fold, flatten, rip, insert bend and no bend commands in SOLIDWORKS. Basically, fold and unfold commands are used to unfold or fold any edge flange of the sheet metal body. Flatten command is used to flatten the sheet metal body. Rip command is used to provide a gap in the sheet metal body. Insert bend are used to provide bends on the outer corners of the body, and no bends are used to remove the bends from the body. So let's see one by one in SOLIDWORKS. So let's see how to use the unfold, fold, rip, insert bend, bend and flatten commands in SOLIDWORKS. So let's go in SOLIDWORKS first. Click on the new tab. Click OK. Select the front plane and click on the sketch. Select the rectangle. Exit the sketch. Click on the base flange. Select the rectangle. Let the thickness be of 1 mm and the other factor be the same of 0.5. Click OK. Select the edge flange option and provide the flange on all the sides. Select the edges. Let the distance be of 100 mm. Click OK. Now we'll see the first option, that is unfold. So basically unfold is used to unfold this flange. Click on the unfold. Now first it is asking for the fixed face. So this center base flange will be our fixed face. Now here we have to select the bends to unfold. So we can select these bends to unfold. Suppose I am selecting two bends for now. Just click OK. So this will basically unfold the two bends I have selected. Now if you want to again fold this, we'll select the fold command. It is automatically selected the fixed face. Now go in the bends to fold and select the bends to unfold. It is to fold. Click OK. Now again we'll see the unfold option. Click on the unfold. Select the fixed face. Now suppose you want to unfold all the flange. So just click on the collect all bends. So it will basically collect all the bends automatically and click OK. So it has unfold all the edges. Now again we have to fold these edges. Click on the fold. Let's select the fixed face. Now here also you can select collect all bends. So it will automatically collect all the bends. Then click OK. See, like this you can use the unfold and fold command. Now we'll see the flatten command. Basically flatten command will be used to flatten the sheet body. So click on the flatten command. So it will flatten all the sheet command. Okay. Now we'll see the other example. Suppose it has been edited on the edge flange options. So suppose we go in the edge flange. Click on the edit feature option. We'll select the edge 2. Click on the edit flange profile. Make it normal 2. Now I am providing a circular cut. Click on the finish. It has provided a cut. Now we'll do other options. Select the edge feature. Select the edge force. Click on the edit profile. Make it normal too. Now I am adding fillet on the corners. Let the fillet radius be of 30. Select the vertex. Click the finish option. So this will basically add the fillet. cut this part and tick again. Now let's go on the edit flange. Click on the edit feature. Let's select the H3. Click on the edit flange profile. Make it normal too. Select the fillet option. Let the fillet be of 20 mm. Select the vertex. Click on the finish option. Cut this fillet portion option. Now let's see how to add fillet. Suppose we want to add fillet, we can go on the corners, select the corner trim option, select the edge and select the fillet option and give the radius. Click OK. Now we'll see how flatten will work on this sheet metal. So click on the flatten. So it will basically show all the operation in the flattened sheet, like it is showing the circular cut and it is also showing the radius. Now if you want to exit from the unflatten, click here. Now we'll see how to use the rip command. Just click on the new tab, click OK. Select the front plane, click on the sketch, select the rectangle, exit the sketch. Now we'll go in features, select the extrude boss option, select the rectangle and increase the distance. Click OK. Now we'll use the shell command, click the face and give the thickness, let the thickness be of 1 mm and click OK. Now basically we'll see the rip command. This rip command, insert bend and no ends command are used to convert the non sheet metal body into sheet metal body. So now we have non sheet metal body, means our body in normal feature option. Suppose I want to go in the sheet metal options and insert the rip, that is to provide the gap. So I have to select the face, click on the sketch, make it normal too, select the line, so I have to provide a gap here, so just draw a line, exit the sketch, click on the rip command, select the line and provide the gap distance, suppose I want a gap of 1 mm and click OK. You can see it has provided a gap of 1 mm, that is it has provided a cut of 1 mm. Now let's see how the insert bend and no bends option work. Create a new tab and click OK. Select the front plane, select the sketch option, select the center rectangle and create a rectangle, exit the sketch, then go in the feature and select the extrude boss command, let the press be of 100, click OK. Use the shell command, select the face and let the thickness be of 1 mm. Click OK. Now we'll go in sheet metal and use the insert bend option. Basically it will provide the bend as we have seen in the sheet metal parts. Now our body is in normal feature, so we'll go in the insert bend option. It is asking for the fixed face. I'll just set the fixed face. Now we'll go in the rip parameter, that is basically we have to select the corner to rip. So I'll select this corner, this will select corners one by one. Now we have selected all the four corners and from here we can add the radius we want. As we have seen in sheet metal, suppose the radius be of 1 mm. Now here we can provide the gap distance. Let the gap be of 0.5. You can provide relief you want. Suppose let the relief be rectangular. just click OK. Click OK. See, it has converted from the normal feature body to sheet metal body. And like in sheet metal, we provide gaps. So by using the insert bend option, we have provided the gap on the corners and also the bend radius. See, like this. And if we don't want this bends, so just simply click on the no bends option. So it will just revert all the options we have used using the insert bend option. And suppose we want all the bends again, just click on the no bends. So it will again come back to the same earlier positions. So like this, we can use rip, insert bend and bend command to convert a non-sheet metal body into sheet metal body. Thank you friends for watching this video.